Welcome to Maxability. To unfold different layers of knowledge, stay tuned with us till the end of the video.
Hello everyone. Welcome to the series Using Mac with VoiceOver. This is lesson 11. And in this lesson, we are going to learn how to access the menu bar using VoiceOver on a Mac computer. Menu bar is a quite common feature in any application, and we need to use it to access various controls, various functionalities of the application. So let us today understand how to access different features of menu bar. And I am taking the application of Safari for the demonstration purposes. Let me see if I have opened my Safari browser and what web page I am on. The command is VoiceOver keys plus Shift plus I.
Home, Maxability, page has 45 links, 16 headings, 5 form controls, 4 landmarks, 1 image.
I am on the browser with Maxability homepage opened. Now to access the menu bar, I have to press the VoiceOver key plus M for menu bar. That is control option M.
Menu bar, Apple.
It says menu bar, Apple as the first item in the menu bar. I can use right and left arrows or control option, which is VoiceOver keys plus control plus left and right arrows to access different menus in the menu bar. Let me try with using right arrow because Apple is the first item on the menu bar.
Safari.
Safari is the second one.
File.
File.
Edit.
Edit.
View.
View.
History.
History.
Bookmarks.
Bookmarks.
Develop.
Develop.
Window.
Window.
Help.
Help. And this is the last item. If I press right arrow.
Apple.
It is coming back to the first item in the menu bar. I can also use control option. Right arrow. I'm holding on VoiceOver keys.
Safari. File. Edit. View. History. Bookmarks. Develop. Window. Help. Help.
And help is the last item. When I'm using control option right arrow, it is not moving to the first item after help. I'm pressing right arrow.
Apple.
Apple. When you observe the menu items in this menu bar, the menus in this menu bar, observe that all the other menus are common when you compare it with the Windows application. The only difference is the first menu is Apple menu and the second one is Safari. Let us see what options do you have or what menu items do you have in these two menus. When you are on Apple or whichever the menu you are in, press down arrow to move into the menu. I'm pressing down arrow.
Apple menu.
Apple menu.
About this Mac.
If you want to know which Mac operating system are you running currently, this is the feature that you can access. And interestingly, you can access this Apple menu in any application that you use.
System settings ellipsis.
System settings.
App Store. 5 updates.
App Store. You can access App Store from this menu.
Recent items. Submenu.
Recent items. You can access the applications that you have recently opened from this recent
apps, recent items, submenu.
Items, menu item. If you press right arrow, you'll go into the menu items and whatever the applications that you would have opened recently will be accessible from here.
Force quit ellipsis command option, escape.
Force quit applications.
Sleep.
Sleep.
Restart ellipsis.
Restart.
Shut down ellipsis.
Shut down. You can shut down your computer, restart or sleep from the Apple menu bar anytime you want and from any application that you want.
Lock screen command control Q.
Of course you can lock the computer.
Log out Rakesh ellipsis command shift Q.
Log out.
About this Mac.
And the first item repeats. And as you would imagined or thought for, you can press right arrow to go to the next menu.
Safari menu.
Safari. And press down arrow to go into the menu items within this menu Safari.
About Safari.
About Safari, again, you can see what version of Safari are you running on your Mac. And if there are any other details of Safari, you can find them here.
Safari extensions ellipsis.
Extensions you can access.
Settings ellipsis command, comma.
settings,
privacy report ellipsis,
privacy report,
settings for maxability.co.in ellipsis,
settings for the specific web page that you have opened,
clear history ellipsis,
clear the history,
services, submenu,
services,
hide Safari command, H.
Hide Safari. You can hide this application from here.
Hide others command option, H.
You can hide other applications other than Safari from here as well.
Quit Safari command, Q.
Quit Safari. You can just use command Q, or you can even access closing Safari from here. Sometimes the application that I want to close will not close with command Q. So in such a cases, I'll come to this menu and use quit that application, and it automatically gets closed.
About Safari.
And about Safari, coming back to the first item on the screen, on the menu bar. So similarly, you can go into the file.
File, menu, edit, menu,
edit,
view, menu,
view, and so on and so forth. So I'm not going to talk about each of them now, but you can experience on your own. Let us quickly see one other application so that you can understand the difference between the first two items.
Microsoft Word. Word, visited, link image, comma, maxability logo, page one con.
I am on the Word.
Document one, page has, two form controls.
And I can press Control Option M.
Again. Menu bar, Apple.
And it says menu bar and Apple. The first one is again Apple in this application as well. And if I press right arrow,
Word.
It is Word here. There you have Safari.
File.
And as usual, the rest of the items will be same. And if I go back to
Word,
Word and see what options are here.
Word, menu, about Microsoft Word.
About Microsoft Word.
Preferences ellipsis command, comma.
And the rest will be mostly the same.
Sign out ellipsis.
Sign out.
Services, submenu, hide Word command, hide others command option, quit Word command, about Microsoft Word.
Okay, these are the same. So that is how you access menu bar on Mac computer for any application that you are accessing. Hope this video helps you in enhancing your knowledge of VoiceOver on a Mac computer. Thank you for watching this video. Do not forget to share, subscribe, and like this video. Thank you very much.
Thank you for watching and being with us. Please like and share the video. Don't forget to click on the bell icon. And also, for more updates, subscribe to the channel.